All right, Thrive Nation, there comes a time where all of us wake up, we look in the mirror, and it occurs to us we're not happy with the direction our life is going. We go to the bank, and we recognize our bank statement isn't what we think it should be. There's a time where somebody asks you, so how's that business going? And you say, I don't want to talk about it. There's a time where we dust off the old Tony Robbins or Think and Grow Rich book by Napoleon Hill, and it occurs to us we've read a lot, but we haven't implemented a lot. There comes a time where we recognize that if we are going to achieve success, we're going to have to do things a little bit differently than we've been doing them in the past. And so what we try to do on the Thrive Time show is when possible, we try to bring real-life thrivers onto the show, real people that have actually gone from just surviving to thriving. We try to bring people onto the show so they can share their story and they can share about how they've diligently implemented the proven systems and processes that we teach. Because if we taught these system stairs and people didn't implement them, it wouldn't work, right? We need somebody who's a diligent doer.
Exactly.
We can teach the proven processes, but we need somebody who's a diligent doer, somebody who's going to implement these words. And so I'd say every morning at our Thrive Time show offices and at the Leadership Initiative, we celebrate wins of the week. Some days there's 4 or 5 clients setting records. Some days there's 10. Some days there's more than that. But we like to have them on the show so we can celebrate their wins of the week. And so now, without any further ado, it is now time for yet another edition of
Wins of the Week.
I think boom. Doing the bull dance, feeling the flow.
Oh, Thrive Nation, you can do it. Now, Sean Lohman with the Leadership Initiative. Who is today's success story?
We have Mr. Jeff Pell up there in the mountains of North Carolina with his company, Skyhouse Company, where they build incredible second and third homes for people.
Jeff, what the Pell is going on? How are you, sir?
I love that you used that.
I see what you did there.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Now, hey.
I'm doing great.
You're doing great. Well, what's your website? I know somebody out there wants to look you up right now to verify that you are, in fact, the owner of a real bona fide business. What is the actual web address there?
Sure. Skyhousecompany.com.
Skyhouse. Let me see. Skyhouse. Fingers on the home row. Skyhousecompany.com. I'm going to go there right now using the power of the interwebs. And I'm looking at some beautiful construction up here. Do you do... renovations, custom homes, do you do all of it? What exactly do you do?
Yeah, we focus on new construction and also renovations and additions, but mainly the focus is with architecturally driven designs.
Dude, listen here. I'm on your website. I'm clicking on the gallery. I go to skyhousecompany.com. I click on the gallery. It looks like you're building like an Ewok village here. Do you recall this property here with the Ewok? It's like a deck in the air. Do you recall that property?
Oh yeah, that was an addition to an existing home that they wanted access to the back of the home from the driveway. In order to do that, we made a catwalk.
It's incredible.
And we made it nice.
It's an Ewok, is what it is. Not it, a
no,
catwalk.
This is incredible. This is incredible. You got one here that has some sort of. It looks like it'd be like a red carpet maybe and stonework out looking over like a mountain. Did you recall that property? It's gorgeous.
Yeah, that's a concrete dance floor on top of a mountain outside of a dance pavilion that we did.
A dance pavilion on top of a mountain. It makes sense. That's okay. I'm this is amazing. I remember when Clay Stairs first started working with you, I went onto your website. I'm looking at the photos, and at first I'm just looking to kind of get an idea of how we can help you optimize your website so you rank higher in Google. And I got pulled in like a tractor beam on skyhousecompany.com. I get pulled in, and all of a sudden I find myself saying, it's like hours have passed.
Oh, yeah.
You know, my it's like my wife has gone to church 2 or 3 Sundays in a row. It's like the office meetings have occurred, and I'm just looking at it, and I can't get off. I mean, stairs, it's like a hypnotic. It's so great.
Oh, yeah, you definitely go to the mountain on that thing.
Are you putting, is it nicotine on the website, or what is going on? I mean, these images are incredible. I mean, do you, how many houses a year do you work on? This is incredible.
Well, I mean, and I've got to update the website, honestly, with new photos that are probably more phenomenal than what's on there, and maybe some professional photography as well. might help me out, but I mean, this year we're tracking for 12 new builds this year, and we've got three huge, you know, pretty big overhauls, addition renovations.
I'm not even kidding.
He's still in the zone.
This is incredible. How long have you been in business?
6 years.
Where are you located? This is incredible. I want to move there just to have you build something. Where are you located?
Banner Elk, North Carolina.
So
we're
tell
like
us
the top northwest corner of the state.
So tell us, what kind of growth have you experienced here since working with the Leadership Initiative in Clay Stairs, as I just gaze at the wonder of these beautiful, majestic renovations?
Well, so when we engaged and started working together, I was solely building my company off word of mouth referrals, right? I didn't even have a website at the time, or I did, but it was more of like a paperweight that was just there because, you know, everybody has a website. And so after investing in the SEO, we've really got the marketing stool in full bore. You know, we're getting leads now just to show the growth. If I'm looking at my lead tracker, I've got $6.1 million in leads contacted. I've got a potential revenue. I've got $8.09 million in potential revenue of appointments scheduled with leads. I've got $3.5 million in the pre-construction design and planning phase with us that are going to move into the production phase. And then in production right now, I have $3.6 million.
Boom.
And so that's for me, it's exponential growth.
I can see it's
awesome.
It's happening again.
Yeah.
I'm getting pulled in. Yeah, shake out of it.
Holy cow.
Shake out. Yeah, shake out. Okay. So Stairs, I mean, this guy, I mean, he's implementing the systems.
Yeah.
The processes. Sean, we got to write this down, though. Seriously, mm-hmm. We got to add more to the gallery because this gallery is phenomenal. Mm-hmm. And we hear a lot, well, the work's so good, it sells itself. That's true, but not unless people can find
you.
You
got to be able to see
Talk about the diligent implementation of these systems, because Jeff has been so coachable, so approachable.
Yeah.
It's been a really neat relationship. You brag on him all the time. What makes Jeff a great client to work with?
Sean, I'm going to defer to you. You're the one that's been working
first
with
First and 10,
Jeff.
And you punt. Wow.
It's a drop kick. Drop kick. Omaha.
Well, as of lately, you know, Jeff, the sales and marketing stuff, we've been working with you for like 3 years now. So that's really started to take off in the last 18 months. But now the problem is people. And you just resisted some of those hiring systems for a while. Can you talk about why you resisted them? And now where are you at with them to build your team?
Well, I think for me, and this is not everybody, but you can be told something over and over again, but until you feel the pain, the real pain of something, then you may listen a little bit clearer and more be more aware of what somebody's telling you. So yes, forever and ever, you guys have had systems from day one for me for a group interviewing system. I fought it. You know, just being busy, not prioritizing a group interview. I didn't see the value in it or the power that it would have until a year ago when COVID hit. And, you know, I had an office manager and some other people that I delegated some high-level responsibilities to decide, you know, and treat it as an Armageddon situation and straight up said they're going to head home and hide behind their curtains. And so at that point, I was feeling the pain of not having a group interview system. And right away, I knew the system. I knew it well. We went over it, and I'm sure Sean and Clay were frustrated a little bit that I wasn't doing it. But guys, I was on board at that point.
I hate to do this too. I just want to share a story because this relates so much. You know, my dad, and how long have you been a client there, by the way? How long have you been a client with Clay Stairs, Jeff?
I mean, it's got to be three plus.
Okay, so my dad passed away almost 4 years ago, 3.5 years ago, okay? Probably about the time you guys started in the program. And my dad, I remember as a young kid, we went to these restaurants, and the restaurants stares. You're a dad, I'm a father, you know?
Yeah.
And you tell your kids, guys, listen, if you're going to order it, you're going to eat it. That's kind of a rule. If you're over 40, you have that rule for your kids. If you're going to order, you eat that.
Uh-huh.
Your kid's got diabetes or 85 pounds overweight, and you're just like, you're going to eat that. Whatever you get, you're going to eat it because I'm over 40. That was a rule.
Happy plate.
So my dad takes me to this restaurant in Monticello, I believe it was, Minnesota.
It's Monticello.
Yeah, Monticello. We go there, and the thing is, it's one of these places where, Jeff, if you eat everything on the plate, you don't pay for the ice cream. But we didn't have any money at the time, and if you don't eat it all, you pay hundreds of dollars, maybe $150. we had no money at the time. We had maybe a total of $150. And so my dad's like, if you order it, you eat it. Well, the table's long. There's a lot of family there. It's a long table. There's probably a dozen, maybe 15 people there. And so I'm able to get one-on-one time with a waitress.
Ooh, trouble.
And I'm like, you know, 14, 13, something, the age where you think you can eat everything, you think you can dominate, you know. So I turn to the waitress, and I'm like, hey, listen, I want my name on that plaque. I want that dessert. She says, you want that dessert? She says, your dad's going to, you know, is he okay with it? I said, my dad's okay with it. My dad says, what, son, what? What are you saying? I'm like, nothing, Dad. They bring it out. It's like a fleet of brownies, like a herd of brownies, at least 12 brownies. I'm not kidding. It's massive. 20 scoops of ice cream, and you got to eat it all. So I begin, and my dad looks like he's going to kill me because my dad has said, much like a coach says, listen, guys, if you don't do the group interview, you're gonna lose the game.
Yeah.
My dad says to me, if you don't eat it, I'm going to kill you. But at a certain point, I realized we can't afford the meal, and he probably will kill me. So I'm eating, and I'm probably 18 scoops, and then the nurse, the waitress slash nurse, she comes by, and the waitress, she says, sir, if you get up, you're disqualified. So I do the classy move. You unzip the pants. You unbelt. You have to unbutton the pants, the khakis.
Yeah.
Because you got to let some more room out.
Oh, yeah.
And now you begin. And it looks like there's a snake in my stomach. I lift it up. And I can see under my shirt. It's like a snake because it's like I'm trying to eat this entire. And my dad's looking like, you'll eat it. Other people are having a good time. And there's a man who's like, you'll eat it. And my mom's like, Tom, calm down. Calm down, Tom. She said, Mary, hell yeah. And my dad doesn't curse or anything, but it's like, so I'm eating this and I'm trying to get it down. And my dad's like, you better eat it. You better eat it. My brother's like, I told you so.
You're going to
I told you so. My dad's like, you better eat it. You know, so anyway, so we're eating, and I finally get it down, and I'm just I could sense I did a bad thing, but I wanted to get on the plaque.
Oh yeah,
and I got on the plaque, and if you throw it up, you lose. You got to pay it back. Ooh. So I got out of the restaurant. My dad puts me in the back of a station wagon because we're from the '80s, where it doesn't matter.
Oh yeah,
he puts me in there, and he's like, "You feel good about yourself? You feel good? I got a picture of my face on this plaque." And there's a lot of entrepreneurs, we get into that kind of that ice cream eating plaque phase. We're like, I don't have any employees. And I don't need any employees because I'm going to build every house myself. And I don't do the group interview. And I don't get reviews. And I don't do my website. And I don't care. But since I'm paying you, I'm going to listen. I'm going to listen because I'm paying you. And maybe you were never that bad. But, I mean, what is that? What is that, Jeff? What are your thoughts on that? That pig-headedness where we all just, you know, think we can eat all the ice cream. We don't want to do the group interviews. We don't want to get reviews. We don't want to follow the system. What is that?
Well, again, I understood it all. I knew that I needed to be doing it. And at the same time, it was not at the top of my priority list. And I was, which it needed to be, because obviously if it's not, if I don't have it, I need to hire somebody. Right. And so it was until it was like until I felt the pain of it and it was like, let's do this. And I'm going all in.
Too much ice cream.
I sponsored a couple of Indeed ads. I ended up having 33 people apply for it. I ended up having to move it to the Home Builders Association banquet hall because my office wouldn't hold it. Ended up having 21 people show up to it. And at that moment when I walked in there, I was almost like, I'm public speaking. This is so big, right?
Yeah.
And all these people are here for a position in my company. And I was able to look around the entire room of a lot of probably qualified individuals and execute this group interview. And it was in that moment where I felt the power of never being leveraged by a single employee ever again in my life.
There it is.
The power.
The power. The power. You feel that, mister?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious.
And don't call me Shirley.
So let's talk about this on just a final thought here. Final thought. You've had a lot of success. I'd like, if you can, to quantify it. How much have you grown as a percentage in the last 3.5 years?
Well, let's quantify. Let me get the scoreboard.
As you're doing that, let me keep a sound effect. This keeps me mildly entertained as you're doing math on an audio-only program.
Stay on target.
Just keep doing that math.
Stay on target.
Just do that math. Keep adding it up.
Loosen up.
Oh! Long division. How are we doing? Checking in on you there, Jeff. We doing good on the math there? We doing good?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. I mean, from 2019 to 2020, this exact week, I grew 233% in 2020. At this exact time in 2021, from 2020, I'm at, it's saying 590%.
Oh, let's get it on.
So total growth, and since you started to now, what is that?
Well, it's got to be at least I've tripled my numbers, my revenue. So 300 and
wow,
it's over 300%.
Wow, and again, what's nice about the 300% growth of your business is that you've been a pleasure to work with. I mean, the guys up here brag on you all the time. They like working with you. You like working with them. I'll let you have the final word on this here. For people out there that are thinking about becoming a client, I mean, right now this is so crazy. The true story. Right now, and I'm going to pull up this on the – guys, I want you to see this on the big screen here. Look at this. We had a person book a ticket for the conference at 521, then 518, 512. This is 502. At 5 o'clock, at 5:50. Karen Smeltzer at 4:43, 4:47. We're getting a person every 2 to 3 minutes now booking a ticket to get out to the workshop. The news is getting out that this workshop, that this coaching, it does work. What would you say there, Jeff, for anybody out there thinking about becoming a client of Clay Stairs and the Leadership Initiative?
It's a no-brainer. If you're serious about not being a slave to your business and you don't know the way out and you're just a diligent doer and you'll simply do what they ask of you and you have the ambition and drive to create something better for yourself and create freedom and have goals and have the abilities and tools to achieve your goals and to have the metrics and the numbers and everything from A to Z covered in a business, it's a no-brainer. But if you want to be a slave to your business and be a technician in it and never get anywhere, then don't do it.
Mm. Nice. And have you been to a workshop yet, sir?
Yeah, two of them.
How would you describe the workshop, maybe versus other, Chamber of Commerce, business networking, those kind of events? I think a lot of people have all been to those other kind of business events.
Oh, well, no, this is it's the no BS school. It's down and dirty to what actually creates results, what you actually need to do. It's action items. It's action oriented. It's solutions to every problem that you could come up with because you guys are pretty much a mastermind class.
Jeff, it's an honor to serve you. I really do believe that it's been an honor to work with you. I know the guys that really enjoy working with you. I hear nothing but great things. I'm going to play a little audio from the first Clay Stairs coaching session with you because Clay Stairs has
gotten better.
He's been a consultant for almost a decade now.
Yeah.
But that first meeting with you was about 3.5 years ago, and I'm gonna play. The meeting was going well, and I think you were telling him you got a few new leads, and he got excited, you got excited, and the growth was there. And let me just cue up the final excerpt from the meeting.
We record our calls.
Let me play the audio. It's incredible. I want to hear what this did for you, Jeff, as a client. Here we go.
And then we're going to Washington D.C. to take back the White House.
When he said that to you, Jeff, how did that make you feel?
It made me feel like I wanted to drive 200 miles an hour.
Final audio clip here. This was from Clay Stairs almost a decade ago. In one of the first meetings he had a client that came in, and this is before Stairs knew all the systems. Because Stairs, you became an entrepreneur at the age of 47.
47. I didn't know. And
this
I
was
just,
like the first client. You have to be a real business owner to be a good fit.
Uh-huh.
If you're not a business owner, it's not a good fit.
Yeah.
And we had a guy reach out, and he was more into feelings.
He wanted to align
his feelings. And he was, you're going, so you don't own a business. He goes, I don't, but I do want to align my feelings. This was the first, I think about a half hour of the meeting. Let me keep just a little segment of the first coaching session Clay Steer's ever had with someone who it turned out to be wasn't a business owner, in all fairness. Let me cue it up here.
A lot of pressure. You got to rise above it. Mm-hmm. You got to harness in the good energy, block out the bad. Harness, energy, block, bad. Feel the flow, happy. Feel it. It's circular. It's like a carousel. You pay the quarter, you get on the horse. It goes up and down and around. Circular, circle, with the music, the flow. All good things.
Stairs, why is it not a good fit for somebody to reach out to you if they're not a business owner?
Because that's what we focus on, is being a business owner. And, Clay, I did spend some time early on in my coaching career doing some life coaching. And it was not my bag, baby. Yeah, it was just a lot of feelings, it was circular, just circular every week, circular. We're back at the same spot again.
Hey, Jeff, what's your favorite band, old school band? Like, if you got to go back in time and you had to, because you're a real guy, what's kind of old school? Let's go back to high school. What was your favorite band or group or song? Or give us an old school jam of yours.
Gosh.
Wow.
We got it. No, it's okay. I think I know.
No, I mean, I can appreciate all genres.
Really?
Oh, there it is.
Okay, let me just play the third meeting with Clay Steer's. No, let me cue it up. Folks, let me tell you what. If you are working with Clay Steer's and you're saying, I want variety in my life, okay, this is what Clay Steer's does to you. If you don't get your action items done, this is what happens. He says, Jeff, I didn't realize you're a new client. And maybe you have failed to get an action item done. And now you get everything done. But you know, those first couple of meetings, Stairs, there's kind of that mutual understanding, like, what's coaching all about?
Yeah.
And this is what we call the penalty box if you don't get your homework done.
Uh-huh.
He cues this song up to you. And I'll let Clay Stairs go ahead and just sing it.
Exactly.
Because this is what he'll do to you.
Yeah.
And you just sit there and you're stuck on the phone with a 40.
You can't just be all about talk, Clay.
You're stuck on the phone with a 50-year-old man just singing to you.
Yeah. It can't just be talk. At some point, you got to do the actions, Clay.
We're going to cue it up here.
Yeah.
Here we go. So Jeff, all the Jeff,
Jeff
Bells
feel
in
free.
There.
Yeah, Jeff Bell, hop in here with us.
Love you is not the words I want to hear you. It's not that I
I've sung this song so many times to so many different clients.
How easy it would be to show me how you feel more than words.
Get your action out of done, folks.
It's all you have to do to make it real.
Get some reviews.
Get those freaking reviews, or Clay Steer's will be, you'll be stuck with him singing at you. One-on-one, it gets awkward.
Love me.
We're in that group interview.
I already know.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Folks, that's...
I hate to have to pull that song out, but sometimes it happens.
If you don't get it done.
24 million views on that.
Yeah, a lot of people didn't get their action items done, folks.
Yeah.
Jeff Pell, thank you so much. If you're out there, Jeff, what is the area of America that you service? If people want to hire you, where in America can people hire you?
They can hire me in Banner Elk, North Carolina.
North Carolina? Do you travel or just North Carolina?
As of right now, I am just in one location.
Yeah. Do you have many people reach out to you from across the country, or are they all right there in
like
Banner
Elk? Like Scandahoovia or Iowa? Or?
Yeah. Milwaukee?
Well, I mean, most of the projects that we're working on are second and third, you know, vacation homes in the area. So they reach out again and want me to come build their primary residence, or, you know, go to Florida or to the coast or to D.C. or to Texas or Colorado.
Yeah.
Right now it's just in northwest corner of North Carolina.
Well, I tell you what, brother, it's an honor to serve you, Jeff. Thank you so much for joining us. And again, folks, check out Sky House Company. The website is Sky. Let me put it in here. It's a skyhousecompany.com. That's the website. skyhousecompany.com. If you want to take your home to the next level and you live in that area, check it out. Jeff, thank you for joining
Thanks,
us, my
Jeff.
Friend. You are a great American.
Absolutely. My pleasure.
Take care. Bye. Now, Thrive Nation, it's often on this show we refer to a man by the name of Sneaks.
Yes.
Some of you have asked, who is Sneaks. Well, Sneaks is a character that I refer to from time to time on the show. And we're now going to introduce you to Sneaks. We've never done this before. Let me call up Sneaks here using the latest, greatest, what we would call telephone technology. And we'll call Sneaks, who's located in an undisclosed location, to talk to him about investing in gold and silver.
Jeff's going to love that we combine these two podcasts.
Oh, yeah.
Does he like gold and silver?
He loves it.
Yeah.
He loves it.
The Hell's Precious Metals. This is Andrew.
Andrew, hey, this is Clay Clark and Clay Stairs and Sean Lohman and the Incredible James here with the Thrive Time Show. How are you, sir?
I'm good. How are you guys doing?
Hey, we're doing rocking. Great.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disclose your name. Let me try it again here. Let me keep the audio here. Let me get this. All right, Thrive Nation. Today's edition of the Thrive Time Show, we introduce to you a man we like to call Sneaks. Should you want to buy gold or silver? From an undisclosed location.
Sneaks on the line.
What you want to do is you want to head to the back alley over there by Alfredo's, the lasagna over there. You get behind the dumpster, and you put out a brown bag, and don't ask questions. You knock twice on the door. Luigi will answer the door. Then you put the brown bag, and you hear like a little, they're kind of shoving a brown bag under the door. It's a doggy door, right? They just wait, and then there, Sneaks will give you the gold and the silver. Sneaks, welcome on, Jeff. No, seriously, Sneaks, welcome on to the show. Sir, for people out there, is it okay if we call you by your real name there, Andrew? Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Or should we use the code name Jeff? Sneaks, or we want to use Jeff?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
If you tell anybody about Sneaks, if you tell anyone, we got to kill you.
Yeah. Okay, so seriously.
The horse's head.
The horse head.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about some stuff. I'm going to go in light.
Yeah, this is good.
But we're going to bring a heavy topic here, okay? In 1971. In 1971, America decided to get off the gold standard.
Thank you.
And this is something that people need to know. Andrew, without going super deep, why is it important for people to know that 1971, America got off of the gold standard? What does that mean?
That's when our dollars basically became worthless. They became fiat currency at that point. Nothing backing them at all.
Okay. So what we need to understand is in 1971, Richard Nixon took us off of the gold standard. Previously, our money, you always heard about Fort Knox. Basically, our money retained its value because we had gold to back the dollar. Stairs, does that make sense to everybody?
That makes sense. There's, for every dollar that's out there, there was some amount of gold sitting around that could back it up.
Okay. And then what happened is through the passage of the 1971, through the Gold Standard Act, we moved off of the gold standard. So now whenever government needs money, unlike you and I, government can simply print money they don't have whenever they need money. So you hear about a $1.7 trillion stimulus package. I think a lot of people are wondering, wow. Yeah. I wonder how they print all that. Are they using a bubble jet or what kind of printer are they using? Wow. I mean, so I want to ask you this. How does that work? You're a gold expert there. But, Andrew, how does that work when government just prints $1.9 trillion for a stimulus package?
No one knows. It's fraudulent, as far as I know. Literally, just the word is that they're actually just taking the gold out of Fort Knox and using it to buy hostages back from different countries and printing dollars off and just telling us that there's gold in Fort Knox still. It's unbelievable. But that's what we're going to do, just print more dollars to do this new stimulus that Biden just passed. It's unreal.
So when we print money, the value of our currency goes down. But again, this is called the Gold Standard Act of 1971. Everybody can look this up, okay? Look it up, okay? Look it up, okay? When you look this up, you're going to find that, wow, the President Richard Nixon got us off of the gold standard in 1971. And now we're going to look up this thing, okay? And everyone needs to look this up, okay? It's called the inflation calculator. An inflation calculator. Now, what you do with the inflation calculator, the actual web address, everybody, for a good time, go to usinflationcalculator.com, usinflationcalculator.com. And we're going to say if in the year 1990 you had put in some money into, let's just say you had some money in 1990, let's go 1990, and let's say you had $100. Why does it appear? Explain how this works. If you had $100 in 1990, why is it worth less now, sir?
It's every year that goes by, our dollar is just becoming worth less, less, and less. It's We need tangible assets. It's the only thing that's real. If you can't hold it in your hand, then you don't own it. And the dollar's just becoming worthless.
So
and just real quick, you guys.
Yeah, I'm sure.
You know who was like helped manufacture this whole idea of going off of the gold standard in 1971 was a very young Alan Greenspan, and he's the guy that he's the guy that's been like a big guy in the stock market for the past like 20 years or so, the Fed chairman, and they knew back then it was destined to fail.
Wow.
So I want to make sure we all get this idea. 1971, we moved off of the gold standard. And then in the year 2000, if you had $100, it would take $154 today to buy what you could buy for $100 in just the year 2000. Now, Stairs, if we go back to Stairs, what year were you born?
I was born 1964.
1964. So here you go. 1964. If you took $100 in 1964, you had it.
Yeah.
And now you would need $846 to buy what you could have bought for $100 in 1964. Now, let's talk about gold. If people want to buy gold, I think we want to clarify this. The value of gold doesn't go up. The value of the dollar goes down. And feel free to correct me because this is what you've been doing. How many years have you been buying and selling gold there, sir?
Since my first job in 1985.
Okay, so Andrew, you've been buying and selling gold since 1985. And if, by the way, if people want to look you up right now, is there a website that people can go to, or do you have a place where you kind of call home on the internet?
Yes, there's a shortcut to our website that's goldisforever.com.
Okay, so gold is forever. And we're going to have you on the show multiple times, but goldisforever.com. So let's talk about this. The value of gold doesn't go up. The value of the dollar goes down. How does that work?
Ideally, if the dollar is becoming less and less valuable, that makes the asset of gold just continue to go up in price. They're supposed to counteract each other. Ever since the financial crisis back in 2008 and the stimulus packages and the quantitative easing that followed that, it's not worked the way that it's supposed to. We're really needing a giant reset. And I believe that's what Donald Trump was actually trying to do. So we need a reset because the dollar is actually becoming worthless, and China is about ready to overtake the U.S. dollar as the world's reserve currency.
I'll put a link to this from Forbes, an article from Forbes, August 15th, 1971, a date which has lived in infamy, so people can learn more about this. But let's get really practical. If I'm a school teacher listening right now, then Stairs has a question for you.
Yeah, I've just got a quick question here. Gold is forever. Is that the website goldisforever.com?
Yes.
.com. Okay. I'm having problems getting there, Andrew.
Yeah, we just both typed it in.
Let me give you a different.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll give you a different address. It's BH like Beverly Hills.
BH.
PM like precious metals. .com.
BHPM.com.
Now we're there. There we go.
All right. Yeah. There we go. And you go there. So let's just say if I'm listening right now, and I'm just trying to give some very real examples. Talked to a lady, 2 weeks ago? Listens to our show all the time. It's interesting how people like this reach out to us. But she says, hey, I'm coming to the conference in April. By the way, folks, if you haven't yet bought your tickets for the April 16th and 17th conference, right now in Stairs, I was telling you about this earlier, General Flynn is going to be there.
Yes.
Folks, you can't get a bigger speaker. General Flynn's going to be there. Lynn Wood is going to be there. You've got Ann Vandersteel is going to be there. Mark Victor Hansen from the Chicken Soup for the Soul is going to be there. The best-selling author in the history of the world.
That's crazy.
The guy sold 500 million copies. He's going to be at the Thrive Time Show conference. But she reaches out and she says, hey, I've got – this is a lady. Again, she's in her 70s. She's got a couple $100,000 of cash saved, and she's planning on using that for retirement. She's on a fixed income.
Yeah.
And she said, should I be buying gold? Again, you're not giving financial advice. You're not saying specifically go do this, but let's speak to people out there listening who are north of 60, who've got a couple $100,000 of cash. What should they be doing with it?
They should absolutely be parking some of it into gold. It's what I've found in doing this for as long as I have is that people in the 65 plus age group, they're the sons and daughters of adults that lived during the Great Depression. And growing up at that time or shortly after is a completely different mindset than now.
Yeah.
Because that was the last time that the United States truly experienced some of the terrible hardships that other countries go through even today. So those people make up the biggest group of who I talk to and who I help provide gold and silver to.
Wait a second, Andrew. We got a guy named Andrew who's a member of the Thrive Time show. Andrew, before you leave, Andrew is a guy who's going to have some questions for you. So before you take off, I want you to, because I know Andrew is buying real estate right now. He's a big saver, Andrew, I want to have an opportunity for you to be able to ask a question here, because again, people in my office ask me all the time. They say, "How do I buy gold?" So, Andrew, slap on some headphones real quick. This guy, Andrew, you save a lot of money. What percentage of your income do you save?
Yeah, right now we pretty much save my whole income and live off of Mana's income.
Your wife's income. How old are you?
22.
How many houses do you own?
Wow, he's counting.
Right now, 3.
Amazing.
But soon to be 4.
Okay, but you live off your wife's income entirely. You save. Mm-hmm. He's worked in our office for almost 4 years. Andrew, what questions do you have for the great one, codename Sneaks. Andrew Sorcini, about buying gold?
Yeah. Hey, so, Andrew. Hey, how you doing, man?
All right.
Good. Hey, one question that I would have is, if you did purchase gold, how liquid or fluid would it be if you needed to invest into something else or needed the money, or what does that look like?
Oh, it's so fast. The way that you would sell it back to me is you just call up and you just say, "Andrew, I've got 15 ounces of gold that I'd like to sell back to you. What is the quote for the 15 ounces of whatever gold it is for this today?" I give you the quote. You say yes. I email you a FedEx label. You slap that on a box, pack it up, and ship it on over to me fully insured.
Beautiful.
You get a wire transfer the next day.
Next day.
Andrew, you got to have another question. I know someone's going to ask me in our team meeting, should I be buying gold? Should I be buying silver?
Yeah. Yep.
Stairs, you had a hot question.
Yeah, I've got some. Andrew, talk to us a little bit about, not everybody out there has $250,000 sitting. So what should people be anticipating? I mean, I know where the price of gold is right now, but can somebody buy, like, I want to buy an ounce of gold. I have $1,800. Can I buy an ounce of gold? What kind of options are there for people that have some money but not a ton of money, and they want to convert over to gold or silver?
They should absolutely just give me a call, take the number right off the website, and just have a little chat with me about what their short-term or long-term goals for gold or silver are and what dollar amount that they could start with. If they wanted to just buy 1 ounce of gold, of course, I would sell you 1 ounce of gold. But I would recommend that you go with silver, because you could get more bang for your buck.
There it
and
is.
And silver has a better chance to double or triple than gold.
Wow.
So let's go to Whole Foods for a second. Andrew, do you go to Whole Foods? Do you go to Walmart? Do you go to Sprouts? Where do you buy your stuff?
Docs.
You go to Docs. Foods. The other Andrew. Andrew, the gold.
We
gold
got bucks. We got Sneaks. We got to go to Sneaks.
We got to go to Sneaks at the moment.
You go to, where do you go, Sneaks?
Sneaks, where do you go to shop?
I'll go to Whole Foods or Ralph's. We have Ralph's out here.
And Andrew, number two, the young whippersnapper who saves all of his income. Where do you shop?
Docs.
Docs.
Country Mart.
Okay.
Here in
Bixby. Have you ever tried to whip off a little piece of silver and say, "So I've been talking to Sneaks. I want to get some avocado season, some silver." Have you ever tried to do that?
No.
Why?
I haven't.
Why?
Just never thought about it.
Answer the question. I think that would be the concern that I would have is when you're trying to buy something with silver, should the dollar fall apart? I mean, how do people actually take that? I mean, do people take payment do people take silver and gold as a payment? Andrew, aka Sneaks.
Yeah, they do. It's estimated that really it's only about 1-2% of the population, but there are people that do. One example that I know of where that actually happened was during Katrina, when Louisiana in the New Orleans area was completely flooded, and there were people that were blocked off from being able to get to areas where they could get supplies and food, and they were trading whatever they could to be able to get that. And there are stories of small silver coins, smaller denomination silver coins being traded for things like generators and food.
So your website is bh-pm.com, bh-pm.com. You did not reach out to us and say, could I be on your show? We reached out to you because the state of Oklahoma has a Secretary of Commerce, like every state, and the Secretary of Commerce for the state of Oklahoma recommends you. So you come highly recommended, not just by anybody, but by the Secretary of Commerce for the state of Oklahoma.
Boom.
We have time now for a final three questions in 90 seconds. I'm going to start with you, James. You're an attorney. Then we'll go to you, Andrew. Then we'll go back to Stairs. We'll go to Sean. So I guess four questions in 90 seconds. Make it quick, James.
Okay, Sneaks, nice to meet you. And Clay, Stairs, thanks for the introduction and all that.
Yeah,
stay on target.
All right.
Hey there.
So I have this is what's been puzzling me for a second. Okay, so let's say that you have whatever supply of precious metals that you have. Let's say you have a chest full. I just want to make this a very, very simple example, right? You have a bucket of silver. If you exchange that for $100, you now have $100 of fiat currency, and you've given away your bucket of silver. So what do you then do with that $100 that you have that could be worthless?
It's that's a disastrous scenario, and I hope that nobody would ever do it. It's a disastrous scenario. You're doomed. But I'm sure there's plenty of people out there that value the paper dollar more than silver.
Let me share up a more realistic scenario. Yeah. So, Mr. Golden Silver. So, if you within a hot tub at the hotel, and you decide to just go in without anything because you think no one else is up yet because it's three in the morning. If you hop in completely without anything on at all, you hop in the hot tub, and then somebody else, like a little old lady, decides to hop into the hot tub. Should you tell her that you was without clothes, or you just try to play it off like, hey, everybody, baby, she doesn't have good vision? That's something I'd like to talk about if you have time. Okay, back to you, Andrew.
I'd absolutely play it off.
You heard it from the gold and silver guy.
It is.
Okay. Snakes. Andrew.
I would.
Yeah. Andrew, what question do you have there, sir?
I actually have two quick questions.
Oh, wow.
Do you recommend buying in bulk or more of a dollar cost average where you're consistently buying a certain amount per month, per week,
You're referring
year?
To buying towels or gold?
Towels, of course. Yeah. Is that not what this is?
Stay on topic.
Yeah,
stay on target.
Yeah, if you're just working with a little bit, I would just scale in. What you're talking about is scaling in. And if you ever sold it, I would scale out. Hopefully you never sold it. But to just do bit by bit by bit by bit. But most people that are of retirement age just do one purchase at one time. And right now, you're lucky to get whatever you can get because there's been a big run on gold and silver. The U.S. Mint has sold out of their key gold and silver products for the whole year.
Wow.
And that's really put a lot of pressure on the inventory
for the whole year.
Everything else out there.
Third month of the year, we're sold out for the year. Unbelievable. Clay Stairs, we have time for one more question for you and then probably a very deep question for me. So no matter what question you ask, I'll probably one-up you. I don't want you to feel bad about that, but I'll probably – you go with your question.
Yeah.
Then Sean can one-up you, and then I'll triple one-up him.
Sounds good.
Good luck.
Okay. Let's say I want to convert $500,000, half a million. Are you able to help me with that? Can that happen?
Easily.
Okay. And what would be that time frame on that? Is that like 3, 4, 5 days, 3, 4, 5 weeks? What's the time frame on that showing? And what does it look like? How does it show up at my house?
Excellent question. So let's say that you call me and you let me know that that's exactly what you're looking to do. I would make a recommendation, a percentage of gold versus a percentage of silver.
Okay.
Right now, I'd probably go 75% silver, 25% gold. You say yes. I email you a trade ticket locking in the price. Mm. So if tomorrow it goes up quite a bit like it did today, you're locked in at the lower price.
Okay.
You wire funds tomorrow or the next day, whichever works best for you. Wire funds to us, and then we ship usually within 24 hours, if not the same day.
You ship gold. Do you also ship your pants?
I would. I don't think they're worth anything. But I might have some old 36s.
Yeah. Okay. And when it shows up on my doorstep, what is it in? Is there like a Brinks truck that pulls up in my driveway? What does that look like?
Actually, they show up in FedEx or boxes, plain brown boxes wrapped like every which way by strapping tape via FedEx, and they're fully insured to your doorstep.
Fantastic.
And
It's the most amazing thing.
Yep. Do you provide 3 lead pipes for every 4 orders of gold? Okay, John, what question? Final question.
All right, so I'm going to try and keep this simple. I've heard about the price of silver and gold being kept artificially low by nefarious people who have the power to do that. Is there any truth to that? If so, why would they want to do that? How could they do that? What's going on there?
It's J.P. Morgan has the – it is true, and J.P. Morgan has the biggest known stash of silver out there. They have 600 million ounces. Wow. At the same time, they have a massive short position on the silver COMEX market, and it's like borderline fraudulent. So that's why we don't see silver move. Everything else during COVID has blasted off. We've seen gold. We've seen real estate. We've seen Bitcoin. We've seen stocks. We've seen everything. But silver has doubled in price during that time, but it's still about only 60% of the value of where it was at its high in 2010. So it really is.
Let me do this here. I'm going to cue up a 90s a cappella song by a group called Shy. And as I'm playing that, you might be wondering, why would I do that? what is the purpose? And some of you might say, why are we having a show about buying gold? Okay, why are we having? It's the same thought. It's like, why? Why? I don't understand. Ponder yourself. Why are we having a show about gold, and why am I playing 90s R&B a cappella songs? Think about it, folks. We're going to go right to the first chorus, and I'll answer for you.
The very first time that I saw you.
Do you remember Shy, the group Shy? You remember that?
I have no idea.
No? These guys were legit.
I knew right
then. Do you remember this?
They sound legit.
Sneaks, do you remember this group?
I don't. I'm pretty good at this stuff, and I don't remember it.
But to my satisfaction. Shy, remember this group?
Nope.
Go for four.
You guys are not down with the true R&B. No.
Too shy.
Okay, I'll tell you why. Why did I play that? Because I like it. Why am I talking about gold? Because I like it too.
There it is.
I like buying gold. It's a tangible asset. It always goes up in value. And if you want to protect the hard-earned money you've worked for, you've got to invest in, I recommend real estate, gold, and silver, baby. Real estate, gold, and silver. I recommend real estate, gold, and silver. And I recommend that when your state's Secretary of Commerce says, listen, I personally recommend this guy, it might make sense to go with that guy.
Yeah.
So I'm telling you, I know people that buy gold and silver from today's guest, and I think that you should too. So if you're looking to buy gold and silver, I don't make a commission, although I've asked. I don't make a commission, and I encourage you to check out Andrew Scorcini, a.k.a. Sneaks. His website is bh-pm.com. We'll get you booked on the show again. That's bh-pm.com. Thank you for joining us, and I want you to know this, folks, on this audio-only program as we talk to Andrew. Andrew, where are you located there, Mr. Sneaks? What state?
The office is in Beverly Hills. I'm currently in Sherman Oaks, California.
I can just tell you, sir, you smell terrific, and we appreciate you for being here.
Excellent. Thanks for having me, you guys. I hope to be back soon.
Take care. Bye.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's unbelievable. So many people have questions about gold and silver buying.
Yeah.
This guy knows the answers right there, folks. Again, if you want to learn more, go to bh-pm.com. And without any further ado, we're going to end this show with a boom. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, boom.
Well, I'm a mortgage broker. I've been a mortgage broker for 11 years. And we're here in sunny San Diego. He was very engaging, he was very charming, he was very humorous. And his presentation had a very practical side too. So he teaches you things that you can use to make yourself more successful, to make your business more successful. But perhaps most significantly, he's got that genuine enthusiasm. After I listened to his presentation, I mean, I'm a pretty positive, enthusiastic guy as it is, but I'll tell you, after I listened to that presentation, I was just it was like an emotional springboard. A lot of the times I find myself working to the point of exhaustion where I'm running out of time, and that's because I don't have the systems in place. He was fantastic. It was just one of the best presentations I've ever seen. And keep in mind too that I've seen some pretty good presenters in my time. I've seen Jack Canfield, I've seen Tony Robbins. And I'll tell you that Clay made a far greater impact on me than any of those other speakers, as great as they are and as great as they were at that time.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Moore. I'm a pediatric dentist. Through our new digital marketing plan, we have seen a marked increase in the number of new patients that we're seeing every month, year over year. 1 month, for example, we went from 110 new patients the previous year to over 180 new patients in the same month. And overall, our average is running about 40 to 42% increase month over month, year over year. The group of people required to implement our new digital marketing plan is immense, starting with a business coach, videographers, photographers, web designers. Back when I graduated dental school in 1985, nobody advertised. The only marketing that was ethically allowed in everybody's eyes was mouth-to-mouth marketing. By choosing to use the services, you're choosing to use a proven turnkey marketing and coaching system that will grow your practice and get you the results that you're looking for. I went to the University of Oklahoma College of Dentistry, graduated in 1983, and then I did my pediatric dental residency at Baylor College of Dentistry from 1983 to 1985. I established my practice here in Tulsa in 1985.
One of the things that I hear in my world a lot as a business consultant from business owners is they will tell me, Clay, I want you to help me, but my industry is different. And so on today's show, I'm going to introduce you to a wonderful client who's a pediatric dentist. And I also am going to introduce you to a wonderful client who's a real estate agent. And I'm also going to introduce you to a wonderful client who does mortgages, and a wonderful client who's a family doctor, and a wonderful client who trains dogs, and a wonderful client who runs the UPS stores for all of Canada. Then I'll introduce you to a wonderful client who has a massive real estate empire, real estate franchise empire. Then I'm going to introduce you to a wonderful client that sells new homes. Then I'm going to introduce you to a wonderful client who sells insurance. And then a wonderful client who runs a church. And a wonderful client who wonderful client who sells insurance. I think I mentioned that. A wonderful client that has a research lab. And at the end of the day, you'll discover that if you will follow the proven systems that I will teach you at our in-person workshops or through our one-on-one coaching program, it's like bumper bowling for business. It's like if you're tired of throwing gutter balls and you want to have success, this system will absolutely change your life. It's a step-by-step system. It's a linear workflow. It's going to absolutely change your life. And without any further ado, here is Dr. Morrow sharing about how this system has changed his life and his business's life and the lives of his employees and the growth of his pediatric dentistry. So here we go.
Hello, my name is Charles Kolaw with Kolaw Fitness. Today I want to tell you a little bit about Clay Clark and how I know Clay Clark. Clay Clark has been my business coach since 2017. He's helped us grow from 2 locations to now 6 locations. We're planning to do 7 locations in 7 years and then franchise. And Clay has done a great job of helping us navigate anything that has to do with like running the business, building the systems, the checklists, the workflows, the audits, how to navigate lease agreements, how to buy property, how to work with brokers and builders. This guy's just amazing. He's this kind of guy has worked in every single industry. He's written books with like Lee Cockrell, head of Disney, with the 40,000 cast members. He's friends with like Mike Lindell. He does Reawaken America tours where he does these tours all across the country where 10,000 or more people show up to some of these tours. On the day-to-day, he does anywhere from about 160 companies. He's at the top. He has a team of business coaches, videographers, and graphic designers and web developers, and they run 160 companies every single week. So think of this guy with a team of business coaches running 160 companies. So in the weekly, he's running 160 companies. Every 6 to 8 weeks, he's doing Reawaken America tours. Every 6 to 8 weeks, he's also doing business conferences where 200 people show up, and he teaches people a 13-step proven system that he's done and worked with billionaires, helping them grow their companies. I've seen guys from startups go from startup to being multimillionaires, teaching people how to get time freedom and financial freedom through the system. Critical thinking, document creation, organizing everything in their head to building it into a franchisable, scalable business. Like one of his businesses has like 500 franchises. That's just one of the companies or brands that he works with. So amazing guy, Elon Musk kind of like smart guy. He kind of comes off sometimes as socially awkward, but he's so brilliant and he's taught me so much. When I say that, like Clay is like, he doesn't care what people think when you're talking to him. He cares about where you're going in your life and where he can get you to go. And that's what I like him most about. He's like a good coach. A coach isn't just making you feel good all the time. A coach is actually helping you get to the best you. And Clay has been an amazing business coach. Through the course of that, we became friends. I was really most impressed with him is when I was shadowing him one time. We went into a business deal and listened to it. I got to shadow and listen to it. And when we walked out, I knew that he could make millions on the deal. And they were super excited about working with him. And he told me, he's like, I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to turn it down. Because he knew it was going to harm the common good of people in the long run. And the guy's integrity just really wowed me. It brought tears to my eyes to see that this guy, his highest desire was to do what's right. And anyways, just an amazing man. So anyways, impacted me a lot. He's helped navigate. Anytime I've got nervous or worried about how to run the company or navigating competition and an economy that's like, I remember we got closed down for 3 months. He helped us navigate on how to stay open, how to get back open, how to just survive through all the COVID shutdowns, lockdowns, because our clubs were all closed for 3 months and you have $350,000 of bills you've got to pay and we have no accounts receivable. He helped us navigate that. And of course we were conservative enough that we could afford to take that on for a period of time. But it was, anyways, great man. I'm very impressed with him. So Clay, thank you for everything you're doing. And I encourage you, if you haven't ever worked with Clay, work with Clay. He's gonna help magnify you. And there's nobody I have ever met that has the ability to work as hard as he does. He probably sleeps 4, maybe 6 hours a day. And literally the rest of the time he's working and he can outwork everybody in the room every single day, and he loves it. So anyways, this is Charles Kolau with Kolau Fitness. Thank you, Clay. And anybody out there that's wanting to work with Clay, it's a great opportunity to ever work with him. So you guys have a blessed one. This is Charles Kolau. We'll see you guys. Bye-bye.
The Thrive Time Show, 2-day interactive business workshops, are the highest and most reviewed business workshops on the planet.
You can learn the proven 13-point business systems that Dr. Zellner and I have used over and over to start and grow successful companies. I mean, we get into the specific steps on what you need to do to optimize your website. We're going to teach you how to fix your conversion rate. We're going to teach you how to do a social media marketing campaign that works. How do you raise capital? How do you get a small business loan? We teach you everything you need to know here during a 2-day, 15-hour workshop. It's all here for you. You work every day in your business, but for 2 days you can escape and work on your business and build these proven systems so now you can have a successful company that will produce both the time freedom and the financial freedom that you deserve. You're going to leave energized, motivated, but you're also going to leave empowered. The reason why I've built these workshops is because as an entrepreneur, I always wish that I had this. And because there wasn't anything like this, I would go to these motivational seminars, no money down, real estate, Ponzi scheme, get motivated seminars, and they would never teach me anything. It was like you went there and you paid for the big chocolate Easter bunny, but inside of it was a hollow nothingness. And I wanted the knowledge, and they're like, oh, but we'll teach you the knowledge after our next workshop. And the great thing is we have nothing to upsell. At every workshop, we teach you what you need to know. There's no one in the back of the room trying to sell you some next big get-rich-quick, walk-on-hot-coals product. It's literally, we teach you the brass tacks, the specific stuff that you need to know to learn how to start and grow a business. And I encourage you to not believe what I'm saying, and I want you to Google the Z66 Auto Auction. I want you to Google Elephant in the Room. Robert Zellner and Associates, look them up and say, are they successful because they're geniuses or are they successful because they have a proven system? When you do that research, you will discover that the same systems that we use in our own business can be used in your business. Come to Tulsa, book a ticket, and I guarantee you it's going to be the best business workshop ever, and we'll even give you your money back if you don't love it. We've built this facility for you, and we're excited to see you.